It's a G light, swerving in a G ride. Who bang, homie, clutching on the 4-5. Don't ever slip, cause you do, boy, that lead flies. Cause at the bottom, we stay hunting in that moonlight. You hear the click, you hear the bang when we pass by. This ain't a game fool, the riders really earn strife. That's on the gang fool for everyone that main line. And it's a thin line, so homie, better act right. We keep it active, really active up on this side. You hear the whistle as they're throwing up their gas sights. The crime rate in the hood always stays high. Banging for the bottle, ducha for the one time. We stay posted, drinking till the sunrise. We stay posted, drinking till the sunrise. Is that G life, swerving in the G ride. Who bang, homie, clutching on that 4-5. Don't ever slip, cause you do, boy, that lead flies. Cause at the bottom.
G file.
Now, starting off right here in South Central, you have the Barrio 40, 40th Street. Now, 40th Street is a neighborhood that has already been right here in South Central since the late 70s, early 80s is what I was told that this neighborhood was established. Now, Barrio 40th Street has no connections to 42nd or 41st Street or none of those, you know what I mean? Like I have said, all these neighborhoods are their own individual neighborhoods. The 40s is just like the 30s and 20s. They tend to have like a few neighborhoods, you know what I mean? Within this side. Now they're located right here on 40th Street in South Central. You know what I mean? Like in the midst of battle right there with like 42nd Street, 41st Street, and all those neighborhoods, you feel me? Now the 40th Street is roughly, I have to say, is the smallest one out of all the 40s. You know what I mean? You know, they were never a large neighborhood. And it just makes recruitment a lot harder because of all the neighborhoods that are right there. You feel me? But nonetheless, you know, 40th Street was still holding it down, representing for theirs. And still right there representing till now. You know what I mean? Like I said, they may be a smaller neighborhood than the rest. And their neighborhood may not be as large, you know, in territory-wise. But nonetheless, homie, they still hold down their section and you know what I mean, and they still be putting it on the map. But that's what's up with the 40th Street neighborhood right there representing. Now right here in South Central, we also have the CEW neighborhood. Now the CEW neighborhood stands for Crazy Evil Winos. And they're located on the west of South Central, right there on 53rd Street is where they're located at. That's the heart of their hood and everything like that. Now, I can't confirm that if it's a 1-3, that's what they say, that's what they put. But I can't confirm it because they used to be a tagging crew, a tag banging crew. You know what I mean? That was around roughly since the 2000s, 90s, 2000s, late 90s, early 2000s is when this neighborhood was established. So it's roughly small. You know what I mean? You know, because they're not as old school as some of these other neighborhoods. You know what I mean? And the fact that they, you know, used to be a crew. But nonetheless, homie, you know, they be doing their thing because you do see the activity by these guys because, you know, the graffiti is everywhere. So, you know, it looks like they still be active and get it cracking. But that's what's up with the CEW neighborhood, which stands for Crazy Evil Winos, and representing for the west of South Central and putting their barrio up on the map. All right, right here in South Central, you also have Barrio Vernon Hood Locals, the VHLS neighborhood. Now, VHLS, I know that there's some people saying that it's not a real hood. This is a real hood. It was established since the 80s. Roughly, it was always a very small neighborhood. You feel me? I was told that roughly under 50 members. So, you know, it was never a large neighborhood. You know what I mean? Now, their neighborhood is located right there in South Central on Vernon and what runs through 46th Street. That's their neighborhood. You know what I mean? So only about like two blocks is their territory, you know, roughly a small neighborhood. But even though it's a small neighborhood, you know, they were doing their thing, you know, right there on 42nd and 42nd to 46th is where their neighborhood was at. And they kept it, even though, like I said, they may not have been large or as old school as some of these neighborhoods. I mean, they were doing their thing, you know, because they were roughly under 50 heads, but they managed to hold their ground until today. You know what I mean? You still catch this neighborhood around. You still see the graffiti by these guys. Not as much as like the other neighborhoods around here, but nonetheless, homie, they still be doing their thing and representing right there for the Barrio Vernon Hood Locals. But that's what's up with them right there. Another neighborhood that you have right here in South Central is the Barrio WNBS or the WNLS. This is one of those neighborhoods where they you see it up in two different ways. You feel me? And now that's standing for Washington Boys or Washington Locos. Either one is proper. You know what I mean? There's some people that think that it's two separate neighborhoods, but it's not. It's the same barrio, you know what I mean? But just sometimes they write it Boys, sometimes they write it Locos. That's just how they get down, you feel me? And the barrio, Washington Boys, is located right here on Washington Boulevard, you know what I mean? What stretches out through right here, hence where they get their name from. And right there on Washington Boulevard and San Pedro is where their barrio's at, you know what I mean? That's their home dojo, their domain, you know, where they be doing their things. And also on Main Street, because they do have the Main Street Locos as their clica. That's one of their cliques right there that they represent, you know, that you see up with them. That's also be the reason why some people think that that Main Street and is his own neighborhood, but it is not. It is connected to the Washington Boys neighborhood. You know what I mean? And I was told that this neighborhood is also located in different states. I heard that they were in Washington. I also heard that they were in Salt Lake City. So they're located in different spots, not just right here in South Central. Well, at least that's what I was told. And I also was told that they were also in Mexico, you know, because their neighborhood did have a lot of immigrants in it. You feel me? At least that's what I was told. And the neighborhood was established in the 80s. That's when the Washington Boys neighborhood was established. But like I said, they were always roughly a small neighborhood. You know, you roughly don't see them up as some of these other guys. You get what I mean? But nonetheless, homie, they still put it down right there for theirs. Be representing it and holding it down. Shout out to Lil Scrappy. Shout out to Sneaky. Shout out to all the homies from Washington Boys that be right there representing and still holding it down. You feel me? Now, another neighborhood that you have right here located in South Central is the Barrio Sur 13. And yes, this is the same Sur 13 that I already covered in the West Side. They have a branch over here in South Central. You know, Barrio Sur 13 is one of those neighborhoods that's spread out through different cities. You know, like I had discussed, you get what I mean? You know, so I broke down that part down on the West Side. But right here in South Central, they've been right here not that long. You know, they're not that long that they have been right here in South Central. I was told since the 2000s. And they're located right here on 102nd Street is where you can find the Barrio Sur 13 right here. As a matter of fact, this is the branch in which Sikkim, the rapper, this is the branch in which he's from. He's from the South Central portion of Sur 13. And like I said, Sur 13 is a much larger neighborhood as a whole, but in each individual spot, they're not that large, but you know what I mean? The locations don't stay that far from each other, so you can just count it, you know, as one big hood. You get what I mean? And yeah, homie, they still be holding it down right here in South Central. You know what I mean? They still be doing their thing, representing. I know Sikkim right there representing for them. The guy has a lot of talent. You guys need to go check out his music. Definitely support the homie because he can spit it, homie. I guarantee you'll like his music. But that's what's up with the Barrio Sur 13 representing right there in South Central. Also right here in South Central, to nobody's surprise, you have the South Central 18th Street. You know, they do have a clica over here in South Central, you know, the South Central portion. You know what I mean? Now, they're located right there on 54th is where they're located at, right there in South Central. This is where they have the LGS clique. I think it was Little Gangsters. It was the name of the clica. And like I said, homie, now this portion of their clica is not as large as like the West Side or like the East and stuff like that. But nonetheless, homie, they do have a presence. They already been right here in South Central for a cool minute. You know what I mean? I was told that they've been right here already since the 70s. So they do have a while already that they were here. You feel me? And I already broke down the back thing on 18. You know that they're a much larger neighborhood. They're worldwide and all that. But right here in South Central, it's a lot more of a smaller clique. But nonetheless, they'd be right there in the midst of battle going at it with all the surrounding neighborhoods right there and representing for theirs and putting it down. But that's what's up with the South Central portion of their neighborhood right there. Also right here in South Central, you have the Barrio Mid-City Stoners. And yes, the same Mid-City Stoners that I covered in the West Side. They're also located right here in South Central because their neighborhood is so large that it stretches from what's the end west part of West LA into South Central. So it's like you can say that it's borderline in between both spots. That's the reason why they're located in both spots. You know what I mean? And the Mid-City Stoners neighborhood, like I said, it is the same one as the West. So, you know what I mean? Is, you know, because they're literally right next to each other right there. So they're large in numbers, you know what I mean? Because, you know, Mid-City is a very large neighborhood, well-established. I will be covering another portion of it because they do have an east side, which is located in Long Beach. That's the east side Mid-City Stoners, but this one is still considered the west side Mid-City Stoners. So don't think that they write it like SS. Or they sometimes write SC Mid-City Stoners. But more than not, they tend to write west side or just Mid-City Stoners on its own. But like I said, this is the same Mid-City Stoners as that one, because their neighborhood is that large that it just stretches between both areas. And that's what's up with the Mid-City Stoners neighborhood right there. Definitely holding it down and representing for theirs and putting their water up on the map. Another neighborhood that you have located right here in South Central, you have the barrio CMW. Now, CMW stands for Wicked Minded Winos. Now, Wicked Minded Winos is one of those neighborhoods where I can't confirm that it's a 1-3. That's what they say. That's what they put. But I can't confirm that because I do know that this was a tagging crew before that used to stand for Society's Most Wanted. That was, you know what the crew used to stand for. But, you know, they were a tagging crew that was roughly around since the 90s. You know what I mean? Early 2000s, late 90s is when this crew was around. You know, you could just find them, you know, spread out throughout South Central. It was where they would roam around and, you know, tag and stuff like that. But like I said, you know, they say that they're a 1-3. That's what they put. You know what I mean? But I can't confirm that. But yeah, now, you know, it's a sick-minded winos, and they be holding it down right there in South Central, going at it. It seems like they be going at it with several of the hoods that be around there. You know what I mean? But they be holding their own because they're still around and they still doing their thing. And you know, you definitely see the activity, what all the graffiti and all that. But that's what's up with the CMW neighborhood right there, holding it down for theirs.